If you've been using the free version of DaVinci Resolve and you import some footage that you film from a 10-bit camera like a Sony a7S III, for example, you may be surprised to discover that Resolve is showing these video clips as audio files. And if you try to play them on your timeline, you're just getting a black screen. This is because the free version of DaVinci Resolve does not support playing back 10-bit video in the 422 color space. But do not worry, because in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how you can easily import and edit 10-bit video using the free version of DaVinci Resolve. And keeping with this free theme, we're going to be using a free tool to help you do it. This free tool is called Handbrake, and it is designed to convert many different video formats, and it works both on Mac and PC. You can download it at handbrake.fr, which I will link to down in the video description. Now, once you have downloaded and installed Handbrake, your goal is going to be to use this program to convert your high-quality 10-bit video files that were recorded in the 422 color space on your camera to a similar quality 10-bit video in the 420 color space, so DaVinci Resolve can open and play it back, and you can save $300 by not having to buy the studio version of Resolve. And don't worry, I've tested this, and even with this conversion, the video quality is still virtually identical, so you don't need to worry about losing quality when you convert your files. Anyways, let's now open Handbrake, and first the app is going to give you the option of choosing either one video file or a folder full of files. I'm going to assume that you probably have many video files that you're going to want to convert at once, so you're going to want to select folder batch scan, and then navigate to the folder where your 10-bit files are kept. Then click select folder, and Handbrake is going to start scanning your video files to confirm that it can convert them. Depending on how many video files you want to convert, this may take a bit of time, depending on the speed of your computer and your hard drive. After the analysis is complete, Handbrake will give you a ton of complicated options here, but don't worry, I'm going to make this super simple for you. First, you're going to want to go up to Tools, Preferences, and then you're going to want to make sure under Output Files that Automatically Name Output Files is checked. In addition, make sure that this Always Use the Default Path for Each New Name Generated is unchecked, because that way, whenever we tell our first video file where we want it to be saved, Handbrake is also going to tell all the other video files that they need to be saved in the same location as well, which is going to save you a lot of time and prevent you from having to tell it where to save every single video file. This is going to help Handbrake convert all of your files at once. Then click back. Next, go up here to the preset drop-down menu where it says fast 1080p 30, and we're going to change this. We're going to go over here and we're going to scroll all the way down to the bottom to where it says production, and you're going to want to select production max. This is basically Handbrake's preset that tells the program that you're wanting to edit a video using these video files, so keep them as high quality as possible when converting them. With that selected, Handbrake should change all these settings on all of these other tabs to make them as optimal as possible, but I want you to notice that at the top here, it says that this video file is 10-bit 422, which, as I said at the start of this video, is the reason that the free version of DaVinci Resolve is not capable of playing back your video. So let's fix that now in just three clicks. First, you're going to want to go here to the video tab in the middle. This is going to show you even more complicated options, but what you then need to do is click on this video encoder dropdown and change it from the default of H.264 to H.265 10-bit X265. This is essentially going to tell Handbrake to keep this a high quality 10-bit video file, but change it from the 422 color space to 420. And that's all you have to change as far as settings go for your video. Side note though, if you see other options here, like H.265 with Intel QSV in brackets, or H.265 10-bit with NVENC in brackets, or there could be others if you are on a Mac, just know that you can try selecting one of these options and they should give you a similar video quality, but they may convert your video even faster because they're going to use your computer's dedicated graphics card to convert the video. If you have a lot of video files you need to convert and you want to do it quickly, try experimenting with one of these options if you have them to save time. Just make sure that you select one of the H.265 10-bit options when doing so. In our case, though, we're going to keep it with H.265 10-bit X265. And to finish converting your video files now, all that's left for you to do is go down here to Browse next to Save As and select where you want to save your converted video files to. What I would do is go to where your native video files are, right click, make a new folder and call it converted. So that way you always know where your saved converted video files are. Select that folder, click save. And lastly, all you need to do is go up here to the add to queue button, hit this drop down arrow and select add All, which is going to select all of the video files from your folder to the queue. You should then see up here that the queue icon says the number of video files that are going to be converted. In my case, there were three in that folder, so it's going to say three. And then all you have to do is click Start Queue. And whenever you do that, Handbrake will start converting your video clips into a format compatible with the free version of DaVinci Resolve. Once all of your videos have been converted, all you have to do is navigate to the folder of converted video files and import those into DaVinci Resolve, where you'll be happy to see that all of your video clips are now visible, and you can bring them down to the timeline, and you can play them, and you can view them, and they work. It's magical. We did it. And now you are ready to edit without needing to pony up $300 for the paid studio version of DaVinci Resolve. Now that said, if you see how excited I am, but for some reason you tried to import your video clips and they didn't work for some reason, specifically if you're on Windows and you brought them in and said media offline and you're like, what the heck? Well, just know that I've tested out this process of converting video files in this way on multiple computers. And on one of them, it worked perfectly fine. The other one though gave me issues and it was not letting me import the video files and it was telling me that the converted video files were offline even though I just converted them and they were properly linked. If that happens to you and you're on Windows, like I said, the workaround for you to fix it is for you to go to the Microsoft Store. Yes, your version of Windows does have a Microsoft Store. Nobody ever uses it, but here it is. And what you're going to want to purchase and download is the HEVC Video Extensions plugin. I know I said at the start of this video that everything is free, and so ideally it will be free for you and it should have worked. But if it does not work, I hate to break it to you, but you might have to pay 99 cents. Yes, really. They charge a dollar for this. I don't know why Microsoft charges a dollar for this, but they do. So pay 99 cents for this program, install it, and then whenever you do that, it should work perfectly. It's a bummer that you have to do that, but at least I'm showing you how to fix it. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to see more videos about video editing in DaVinci Resolve, and down in the video description, because I want to help you out even more, I'm going to link to my edit videos like a pro guide. This is a free guide that I've put together that teaches you the most important things that I've learned as a video editor, and it's going to be super helpful to you if you're learning how to use DaVinci Resolve. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.